The Pap Attack.
We don't know exactly how the Egypt saga is going to end, but we did learn something in Cairo. We learned that the only way to deal with political thugs is the old-fashioned way, go to the streets. We knew about that back in the 60s when war protests, civil rights protests, gender rights protests demanded that dull-brained politicians saddle up on our side or else there would be a price to pay. Back then, we understood that we need to meet might with might. We need to meet power with power. As we watched the angry, fully fed-up demonstrators in Cairo, it was one of those memory moments when we finally remembered that angry mobs are much, much more powerful than lapdog politicians who are going to sell their power to the highest bidder. In Wisconsin this week, Republican hack politicians in the same class as Chris Christie or Nick Haley or Haley Barbour, well, they're under siege by crowds of union workers who learned something from what they watched unfold in Cairo. They learned that you don't just cave because the Republican Party and their Republican governors, along with virtually every Republican politician in America, wants to destroy the American Union. Scott Walker's Wisconsin governor says he's going to call out the National Guard to deal with union problems. This Republican's problem in Wisconsin is that decent people teach and take care of state's children. Devoted workers who regulate criminal quality polluters or make the buses and trains run on time or make sure that the state's infrastructure holds together or make sure that the state's elderly are properly cared for. Those decent people watched what happened in Cairo. They're watching what's occurring in Tunisia, what's unfolding in Bahrain and Libya. The same thing that is happening in those places is long overdue. It always occurs when people are pushed too far. And you know what? It's real, real good for democracy. It toppled the government of Bolivia in 2001 and ran the predator corporation Bechtel out of the country like a scalded dog when people were told that government and Bechtel Corporation had privatized their drinking water. They didn't take it. I could recall dozens of scenarios just like that where political arrogance, limitless power and money were forced to take a backseat to the demands of a huge, angry, angry crowd. Governor Walker, thank you for rekindling the power of protest in your state. It's my prediction that this is not going to hold a happy ending for you or your union-busting Republican gaggle. But it's already reminded many of us that angry pushback by angry crowds of victimized people is sometimes all that preserves democracy. You watch it unfold, Governor, in your state.